Let's do some U-substitution examples that are just a little bit more challenging. So here I have an integral of x over x squared plus 11 to the third power. So we've seen before that often a change of variables is very helpful in solving problems like this. And for that to work, we need some piece of the expression u and its derivative du, right? And then we make a substitution. And the ones we've looked at so far, it always works out perfectly. But of course, as you can imagine, the expressions for which it would work out perfectly are very small, right? A very small subset of all the things you could possibly want to integrate. But sometimes, even if it doesn't work out perfectly, we can still kind of play with things a little bit. And so that's what I'm going to show you here. So in this example, let's try letting u equal x squared plus 11. What's inside that third power. Now if we do that, du is going to be 2x dx. Now if I look at my expression, what I actually have left is this x dx. So I'd like to, you know, be able to substitute for that. But here I have du equals 2x dx. But that can actually be pretty easily fixed by moving the constant around. So what I mean by that is I'm going to divide both sides by 2 and write this as 1 half du equals x dx. And I can do that. It's okay to move that constant over there. And now what I can do is I can substitute 1 half du for x dx. And that'll work out. So if I put that in here, I've got 1 over u cubed times 1 half du. Okay. Now you can only introduce constants like this. You never want to introduce a variable. Okay, so only do this with constants. And now I could write this as 1 half. Pull that 1 half out front. I've got 1 over u cubed. That I can write as u to the negative 3. And then I have my du. So now I'm just integrating u to the negative 3. So if I take the antiderivative there, I get u to the negative 2 over negative 2 plus c. Okay, so this becomes negative 1 over 4 u squared plus c. And I want to finish by putting back my original expression, my original u, which in this case was x squared plus 11. So negative 1 over 4 times x squared plus 11 quantity squared plus c. In number 2, we have the integral of sine squared of x dx. So how are we going to approach this one? Well, first of all, we don't know just a basic formula for sine squared of x. We know sine, and we know x squared, right? But we don't know sine squared of x. So maybe we want to use a u-substitution. And remember, so one thing I should mention is this notation means sine of x quantity squared. Remember that. Okay, so maybe you think, well, maybe I let u equal sine x. And that's a good guess. But if you did that, then your du would then be cosine x dx. And there's no cosine x to be seen in this expression, right? So you wouldn't be able to make that substitution. So that's not going to work. Although it's good to try it. Instead, we need something different. And what we're actually going to use is a trig identity to rewrite this expression. Okay? So there's a few trig identities that are often helpful in integrals, and one of them is a sine squared identity. So I'm going to write that down over here. And you should know this. Sine squared x equals 1 minus cosine 2x over 2. And then, we don't need it for this problem, but just so you see it, there's also one for cosine squared. So you should learn these for these kind of problems. Okay, so then we can make a substitution here and rewrite this as the integral of 1 minus cosine 2x over 2, according to this identity, dx. Okay, well, that's a little better. I can pull 1 half out front. Since everything's divided by 2, that's the same as a factor of 1 half. So I have 1 half times the integral of 1 minus cosine 2x dx. And now I can take this antiderivative, although I still do have to make a substitution, right? Because I've got this cosine of 2x. If it was just plain old cosine x, then I could just write down the antiderivative, but this is cosine of 2x. Now before we've just memorized a formula for this, we said that the integral of cosine ax was 1 over a sine of ax, but I'm going to show you how to do that with u-substitution in case you ever forget the formula. So what I can do is I can let u equal 2x, which is just the inside of this cosine function, and then du would be 2 dx. Now I don't have a factor of 2 anywhere in my expression, but I can just rearrange this and write this as 1 half du equals dx and just introduce a constant into the problem. Okay, so that was a lot, but let's actually implement those substitutions. So I still have my 1 half out front. 1 minus cosine 2x is going to become 1 minus cosine of u, and then dx is 1 half du. Okay, so I'm going to bring that other 1 half out front. So 1 fourth integral of 1 minus cosine u du. And now I have all very simple basic pieces that I have explicit antiderivative formulas for. Okay, so integral of 1 would be u minus, okay, so I have this cosine of u, so that's going to give me, well, the antiderivative of cosine is sine, so minus sine u, and then plus c. And then as my last step, I just want to put back in what u is, and u is 2x. So 2x minus sine of 2x with a 1 fourth out front, plus c. And this is my final answer for this problem. In example number 3, we have the integral of 5 over the square root of 1 minus 14x squared. Okay, so obviously our basic antiderivative rules aren't going to work here. So we can try to see if we can find a substitution that'll work. Okay. Now this one isn't so obvious what the substitution should be, so I'm just going to try the first thing that comes to mind. So I'm going to try letting u equal what's under that square root. So I'm going to try u equal 1 minus 14x squared, see what happens. So if I do that, then du, if I take the derivative, would be a negative 28x dx. Okay, now we've been talking in this section about introducing a constant into the integral. So you might think, well, I don't have a negative 28x, you know, in my expression, but maybe I can do this. Maybe I can say 1 over negative 28x du equals dx, and then substitute this in for dx. But that is very bad. Okay, I wanted to mention that because that's a really common mistake people make. Why do I not want to do this? It would be okay if I just wanted to introduce 1 over negative 28. If I just wanted to introduce a constant, that would be fine. But I don't want to introduce an x into my integral. It's not helpful at all, right? I'm trying to get this integral to be in terms of u so that I can solve it. So you don't want to have u's and x's in the same integral, because then what are you taking the integral with respect to? It just doesn't make sense. So you never want to introduce a constant like this. You never want to introduce a variable like this. You can only ever introduce constants in the substitution process. So then, it becomes obvious that this substitution is not going to work. And maybe we need to think of something else. So let's see. Let's think a little bit more about the structure of this example. Does it remind you of anything? Its structure. It almost looks like, it looks very much like the structure or the form for an inverse sine problem. Okay, so let me write that formula up on the board for you really quick. So if you recall, the antiderivative of 1 over the square root of a squared minus x squared dx is inverse sine or arc sine of x over a plus c. And what do we have here? Well, we have this 5 on the top, but that's just a constant. I could pull that out front like this. So we have 1 over the square root of 1. Okay, so that's, I could think of that as a squared, 1 squared, minus 14x squared. So that's a thing that's a little different, right? Instead of having x squared, I have 14x squared. But I can work around that. So let's try to think about how we might use a substitution and make this match the arc sine form. Okay, so what I'm going to do So in my formula, notice I have x squared. So I'd like to rewrite this so that it's something squared. And what that would be then, we're square root 14x quantity squared. Okay, so that might seem a little strange, but it's true, right? If I were to distribute that squared back out, I'd get my 14x squared back. So I haven't changed the problem at all. I've just rewritten. Now from here, we can make a substitution. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to let u equal the square root of 14 times x. And then du, okay, would be root 14 dx. And I don't have a root 14 in my problem, besides what I'm already using for my u. So I want to introduce a constant. So 1 over root 14 du equals dx. Okay, so let's see if this works out. It looks good so far, but let's try plugging things in and see what happens. So I still have my 5 out front. I have my integral 1 over square root 1 minus, well, I let u equal root 14x, so this is 1 over u squared, times dx, which is 1 over root 14 du. Now, I can pull that 1 over root 14 out front, so this would become 5 over root 14 integral of 1 over square root of 1 minus u squared du. And what do I have now? I have exactly the arc sine form. Okay, so then all this is 5 over root 14 times inverse sine of u plus c. And to finish out, all I have to do is plug back in u. So inverse sine of root 14x plus c is my final answer. Okay, so this problem has a lot of information in it. One of the important things is that sometimes the first substitution doesn't always work, and that's completely okay. Sometimes you just have to try more than one thing to find something that's going to help you solve the integral. Example 4 is x cubed times e to the power of x to the fourth plus 12. So a good choice for you might be the power of the e. So let's try that and see if it works. So I'm going to try letting u equal x to the fourth plus 12. If I do that, then du equals 4x cubed dx. Now if I glance back at my original expression, I do see that I have an x cubed, but no 4. But I can easily fix that situation just by solving for x cubed dx, which is what I actually have to substitute for. So I can write this as 1 fourth du equals x cubed dx. And then I can make my substitution. So this integral becomes e to the u times, and then the x cubed dx is 1 fourth du. Now I can pull the 1 fourth out front, so I'm left with an integral of e to the u du. So then my answer is 1 fourth e to the u plus c, and I need to put back in my x's. So u is x to the fourth plus 12, so 1/4 e to the x to the fourth plus 12 plus c is my final answer. And you can always check yourself on these, right? Just take the derivative of this and see if you get the original expression back. And in this case, you would, right? Because the derivative of e to the x to the 4th plus 12 is the e part again, e to the x to the 4th plus 12, but times 4x cubed, right? The 4 would cancel out with the 1/4, and then you'd have your x cubed. So you can always just check yourself in your head really quick. Example 5 is this, right? I have the integral of the quantity 5x plus 7 times the quantity 5x squared plus 14x plus 3 to the 67th power. Okay, so of course I want to try to use some sort of substitution on this. I'm not going to FOIL this to the 67th power. You might be asking yourself, well, how do I choose what u is? And really that's just something that comes with practice. So in this case, maybe you would try u is 5x plus 7, and then you'd get du equals 5 dx, which is all well and good. I mean, I can take care of that 5, but it doesn't do anything with this 5x squared plus 14x plus 3 to the 67. So it's not helpful. So then let's try letting u equal 5x squared plus 14x plus 3 instead. Okay, well, if I do that, then du is 10x plus 14. And while I don't see that appearing exactly in my problem, it appears to be moving the right direction, because at least I've got the right order of x, right? X to the first power, and I've got x's to the first power in my expression, so that's good. So let's see if we can work with this in any way. Right? So I've taken care of the 5x squared plus 14x plus 3 part, but this 5x plus 7 is still out there, and I have to somehow make a substitution for that. But notice the relationship between 5x plus 7 and 10x plus 14, right? Those are multiples of each other. If I factor out a 2 in my du here, I can write this as du equals 2 times 5x plus 7. And then all I have to do is move this 2 over, so 1/2 du equals 5x plus 7 dx, and then I've got my substitution all taken care of. Okay, so what have we done? Well, we've taken 5x squared plus 14x plus 3, that's my u, and then 5x plus 7 times dx equals 1/2 du. So plugging that all in, well, I've got u to the 67th power times 1/2 du. I can pull the 1/2 out front and have the integral of u to the 67th du. Okay, so 1/2, and if I actually integrate that, I get u to the 68 over 68 plus c. 68 times 2 is 136. So 1 over 136, and then u to the 68th. But I want to put back in what u equals, which was 5x squared plus 14x plus 3 to the 68 plus c is my final answer.